In this video, we're gonna focus on the questions. This is admin view, and this is what your member will see. So this is where your question goes. That's exactly how it works here. So this is admin view. This is where your student questions goes. Hi there, Danica here, and in this video, we're gonna go over on the post editor of the LearnDash questions. So in the previous video, we have checked a lot of settings for how the quizzes look and works with the questions and stuff. So if you've missed that previous video, I suggest you check out that one because it's gonna set the foundation for how the quizzes and question works inside LearnDash. So in this video, we're gonna focus on the questions post type editor. And as mentioned, LearnDash has quizzes that it could be assigned to the courses, lessons, topics. And quizzes has its own questions. And there's different types of questions. We have single choice, multiple choice, free choice, sorting choice, matrix, fill in the blank, assessment, and essay. Maybe there's gonna be more later. Maybe LearnDash will create another type. But for now, these are the types that they offer. You could check out their documentation because here they have detailed how each type works and how you could set that up. But as mentioned, if you're planning to integrate your quizzes with points and gamified it, I suggest you check out GamiPress because with GamiPress, you could do lots of different things and assign points type and even trigger some achievement type for your quizzes. So check that out. Maybe I'm gonna record another video on GamiPress soon, but for now, let's just focus on the quizzes and its questions. So for the questions in LearnDash, if you go to the back end, it has its own section. So quizzes and then questions. So if we open the quizzes, right, the one that we did in the past video, you could actually like create your questions directly here. So that's the easy part. I mean, easy way of creating this. So it's like the courses. So they have this builder where you could just create this in one go, in one page. But there's also a dedicated section for the questions if you wanna check that out. So under questions, they have like example, if I click that, you could see the questions. These are admin label again, and then you can see the type, how much points, which or where is it assigned, and then question category if you're using that. On the settings, they have here to like, if we want to enable the question taxonomies, we could use this. Question categories cannot be disabled, so by default it's on. Category management, select a category to update or delete the title. So you could select it here. And then there's also some template if you have a saved template for your questions. Not much going on the settings, but let's open like one questions here. So this is again admin view, and this is what your member will see. So this is where your question goes. That's exactly how it works here. So this is admin view. This is where your student questions goes. For the answers, we also have at the bottom part. So again, just like on the builder, we have the answers. And here you could also select which one is correct. So you could add a new one if you need. And then at the bottom part, there is like single choice options, optional. If different points for each answer is activated, you can activate a special mode. This changes the calculation of the points. So if you wanna give like different points per answer, so you could do that, but I can't click here. Module 2 active. Okay, so you want here. I see. Okay, so this doesn't work. I'm not sure. Okay, so you need to check this first on the side before you can click that. And then it will give you this field for each answer. Let's just say this is 100 points and maybe this one is 20 points and another one. So you could do that if you need to, but that should be for specific purpose only. So maybe you are using that for ranking, or maybe one answer is kind of right or part of the right group of answers. something like that. Haven't used this much yet, mainly because most of the questions that I built are very simple and direct to the point. But if you need that advancement, you could do that. Maybe I could do more testing about this if I have a project that needs this functionality. But do note that for now, that is available for you to use. It also has an option here that says show reach points in the correct and incorrect message. So this is the section where we have that correct and incorrect message that we have configured in the quizzes video last time. So again, if you have missed that video, please check those out because we have done testing and even show you the errors and problems that I have bumped into for the quizzes. Custom messages and other settings that's available on their page. And you could also do a hint here, but again, that's exactly how also this one, solution hint, that's exactly similar. So most of this you could do in here actually, but if you like example, I'm gonna just cancel. If you have like very specific thing that you want to do and you can't see that on this setting, so maybe you want to check out the question page itself, because things like categorizing and so on doesn't exist in this page for now. Next is the settings page of the questions. As you can see here, there is an associated quiz, so you could only select one quiz, as you can see here. So an example, that's how exactly the builder works here, but let me give you an example. Because once the quiz is assigned, once the question is assigned to the quiz, you can't add that to another quiz. One question belongs to one quiz only. So example, if I add this, there's some questions that I build during my test and haven't assigned those in a specific quiz yet. So this is a quiz that we did last time. If we open that on the questions list, so it is admin label only, this one. And if I like assign that to, let's just say final exam. No question deposited. Okay, so I'm gonna need to put some question. So question one, yes. No. Single choice. Okay, so let's try that again. So final exam, update, and I refresh this page builder. So as you can see, this question is now gone from the options. So if I refresh, that means I could, because this question has been assigned to the quiz already or to the one of the quiz, you could no longer grab that again. So another one, we have test. So if I put that here and then assign conclusion, refresh again, there's no longer like all available questions has been added already. So if I try to free some here, some of this one, so maybe this, and then select quiz, refresh. So as you can see, Q1, I could add that in my list, and here it will be updated. So test A. So note on that one, that a question once added to the quiz can no longer be used on the other quizzes. So you just need to create a new one. Now, there is a functionality from LearnDash for cloning. So example, I'm gonna open the questions here. So these are the current questions that we have. And if we clone, like, example, this one, I'll clone that. Immediately, it created that course with exactly similar content here. So if I open this builder, so update and view the course. So if I take this course, I have the content just like originally how it looks or how we have built this. If I open and refresh the questions, You can also see that the questions that I built has been cloned as well. So you could use the clone functionality of LearnDash if you need to. And you can see that. So if you're cloning a course and it has some quiz and questions linked to it, it will also like duplicate that one for you. So as you can see, we have the final exam link to the copy version, and that's exactly similar to what we have here, link to the original version. So that's the questions for LearnDash. Again, I'm gonna link this flowchart that I have because I'm gonna put more details like what you could do, like example points in GamiPress and how you can trigger that here. And these are the types of questions, and again, this may evolve into more later on, and they may add more features, but for now these are the ones that they have. Check out their documentations here, and if you have like any questions specific to the type of question type that they offer, let me know and I may record a video for that. But yeah, I hope this video helps, and if you have any question, please comment down below, and thanks for watching. I'll see you in the next one. Bye-bye.